Now, Pittsburgh's best sports show is about to begin. Call us or tweet us. We got things to talk about on the Ireland Contracting Nightly Sports Call.
All right, Ken, thanks very much. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to another edition of the Ireland Contracting Nightly Sports Call right here on the Bordas and Bordas Hotline, which is always hot for you right now at 412-575-2600. You can also tweet us tonight at KD Pomp, at Ron Cook BG. And we're here talking about two events that happened tonight. In the city, Penguins and Pirates both in action. One at 18,000 plus a sellout. The other, it's hard to see how many people were actually in. I'm not sure what the crowd was announced, but both were wins tonight. The Penguins come away with a big one. We'll start there over Detroit, a team that had been real hard to play against and real hot, as a matter of fact. Excuse me. And as a result, they came in winners of six in a row. So the Penguins had to play their best game tonight, or at least put some, you know, shots at the net, create some opportunities, and they did with 47 shots on goal. Still, Matt Murray had to come up with big saves also because the Penguins at times put him out on an island. Breakaways, two-on-ones, whatever the case may be. But all in all, they come away with a big win, 4-1, which means we still don't know anything, Ron Cook of the Post-Gazette. We still have one more game. This is how tight it is in the Metropolitan Division right now. You're going to go down to Saturday and maybe then late trying to figure out tiebreakers at this point.
Well, we know they're in the playoffs. That's the most important thing. They clinched, as you heard them say, the 13th year in a row, which is just astonishing, their consistency. But they can still finish second. They can still pass the Islanders if things go right. And they can also finish fourth and have to play Washington if they get beat in regulation by the Rangers Saturday night and Carolina wins in Philly. They'd end up tied. Carolina would have the tiebreaker. You don't want to play Washington. You want to get at least a point at home against the Rangers. Get two. Take care of it. Get ready to play the Islanders.
Yeah, it's interesting because the Islanders right now are in a situation where they're probably going to host, most likely.
Penguins can catch them, though, Bob.
They can, I understand. But as it stands right now, it's Pittsburgh at the Islanders. It's been that way for a while, unless something changes on Saturday night. We'll see. But I guess before we get to that point, we should look at the fact that the Penguins have won 13 straight years of getting to the playoffs. That's the second longest streak among four North American major sports, second behind only San Antonio. The Spurs have made it 22 years in a row under Greg Popovich. They've been tremendous. So that's quite a feat, I think, for this organization. And they have what it takes. They got two guys back, Ron. The underlying story here was both Evgeny Malkin and Chris Letang returned. Those are skilled players when you put into the group. And the second story to me was Phil Kessel. Two more goals tonight. He ripped one off. Signature Kessel shot to beat Jimmy Howard off a faceoff win. That, to me, more than any of the goals he scored recently, tells me that he might be turning the corner.
Well, Sullivan talked about it afterwards, said he just sees a more confident player. The puck is on his stick, and he's just shooting it with confidence. I still thought the number one story for me, though, has been what it's been the whole month of March with injuries and everything else. Matt Murray has carried this team, and he carried it again tonight. He's playing the best hockey he's ever played in the regular season. Kessel scoring all of a sudden, get Malkin, Letang back. They seem to be hitting it at the right time. I'm looking forward to the start of the playoffs next week.
Should be amazing. The one thing we've seen is the it becomes a home ice situation for them as they have their places tied up on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, all 3 days of next weekend. So if the playoffs do start on Wednesday, they may have to play back-to-back games Wednesday, Thursday to start this. Who knows how they'll schedule it, but that's one of the hurdles you face this time of the year. The other news tonight, the Pirates. You know, they've gotten tremendous efforts. They could be 5-0, Ron, when you think about it. They're 1-3 coming into tonight. Jordan Lyles with his Pirate debut, and he goes scoreless.
Very nice.
Yeah, and you
pitching
know,
all around was good tonight.
It was. Although they flirted with disaster in the ninth inning, Pablo Reyes made a play he shouldn't have made to allow the tying run to get into scoring position. But a shutout, Reds have been shut out 2-0. The Reds pretty much stink. And quite frankly,
They miss Scooter Jeanette a lot.
Oh, they do.
They've been shut out three of the last five games. I think they've scored six runs all year. They did get second and third with one out against Vasquez. A wild pitch on a strikeout again. And then the single that was turned into a double by Reyes. But Vasquez strikes out the next two pinch hitters, and they got the win. The pitching's been very good. I'm not worried about the bullpen. I think it's going to be better. It was very good tonight. Kingham was good tonight. Richard Rodriguez was good. Then Vasquez. I'm still worried about how they're going to score runs, especially now that Corey Dickerson is going to be out a while with his shoulder injury, and I'm also worried about the defense. I think the bullpen's going to be okay, and it was really good tonight.
Yeah, the defense is something to be concerned about. We've seen too many incidents already. However, the starting pitching has been spot on. Some of the best you'll find in all of major leagues right now through five games. The Pirates win 2-0. We'll talk about all that and more. This is your place to sound off. If you have an opinion, call us right now at 412-575-2600. It's the Ireland Contracting Nightly Sports Call, 7 nights a week here on Pittsburgh CW. The Ireland Contracting Nightly Sports Call is brought to you by Ireland Contracting, celebrating 25 years as Pittsburgh's number one home exterior expert in roofing, siding, windows, and gutters, where honesty and integrity still matter.